Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be talking about how to manifest confidence, which is like the best topic ever. I've been getting so many requests to do a video like this, which I'm so excited. I know everybody wants to manifest like a specific person or whatever, and that's fun. I'm never gonna be one of those people that's gonna tell you what you can or can't manifest, because like I'm not here to judge. I'm here to give you the tools. But I will say it was refreshing to see that people wanted to know how to manifest confidence, because I feel like it's like one of those things that I personally have been like just manifesting more things like that, like manifesting confidence, manifesting, you know, being able to embrace change. Like those are things that I've personally been working on and manifesting for myself, and it's honestly, I feel like easier than trying to manifest like a specific person or something like that, because you're only relying on yourself. So it's like there's less reacting to your reality that you have to worry about. Like obviously there's always going to be moments where you might feel less confident than others when everybody has their insecurities, but like at least it's like within yourself. All manifestation is, but I just mean it's easier in terms of like, let's say you're trying to manifest a specific person and they're like out on a date with somebody else or something. It's gonna be like mentally, you're gonna be like, whoa, wait, like, you know, back up, like, let's not take a minute. But when you're manifesting confidence, you only have to worry about you, yourself. That's all you should be worrying about anyway. Okay, so of course, like with anything else, manifesting confidence, manifesting anything else, all comes down to your mind, your thoughts. So when I talk about self-concept and manifesting, that's like, to me, it's like confidence around your manifestations. So I have a whole other video on that. If that's what you're trying to find, go look over there. And that's like confidence around your manifestations to have less negative thoughts and things like that. It's a bigger thing, but that's kind of what like I associate self-concept with. It's like confidence in relation to manifesting. But today we're just talking about general confidence, you know, just all across the board. So literally it's the same thing as everything else. You are affirming that you're confident. And I know that it's like a lot of manifestation things, it's easier said than done. So basically these are some of those affirmations. Like some people say like, oh, say your affirmations in the mirror. That's not for me, but especially if you're trying to manifest confidence, you could definitely go that route too. And just, you know, it doesn't have to just be like, oh, I'm confident, 'cause that's like, who cares? But it could be things like, I'm so proud of myself. I make myself smile every day. I light up every room that I walk into. My confidence is mesmerizing to other people. My confidence is inspiring to other people. Other people are always asking me how I'm so confident. Like, it's just living in that mindset of being able to be confident in everything it is that you do. You can even say that. I'm always confident in everything that I do. I know that success follows me. I know that I'm at my most confident. I gain more confidence every single day. I feel more confident every single day. I never doubt myself. I'm always so sure of myself. I never question my decisions. I never question my feelings, my thoughts, emotions, whatever. Just repeat things like that. And honestly, I, like growing up, I never struggled a ton with confidence, but I remember watching a YouTube video. I think I was in like middle school, and it was like one of the beauty YouTubers. I don't remember who it was, but anyways, she was doing a Q&A and somebody was asking her like, how do you stay so confident? And she was like, she basically applied like the fake it till you make it attitude. Like, you tell yourself you're confident, over time you'll believe it, and like that's kind of it. And even though I wasn't struggling, I was like, oh, you know, that'd probably be like good for me to say, like, oh, I feel so confident, I'm so, like, I just adopted that mentality. And obviously now looking back, that's very much like how the law of assumption works. You assume something about yourself, you affirm a statement about anything, in this case it's about yourself being confident, so you keep saying that over and over, and not only do you convince yourself, but you start to project that out into the world. So not only do you believe it, but that's the kind of energy that you put out, and that is what people mirror back to you. People, when they see you as a confident person, they treat you differently. They know that you're not somebody that they can take advantage of. They know that you're not somebody that they can, you know, try to manipulate or whatever. And you're not, that confident people are indestructible, but like, it's just, obviously it's a much different tone that you put out into the world, a very different energy that you put out into the world, rather than being insecure or anything. Again, not that that's your fault, but that's why you're here, you're trying to manifest confidence. So it's a much different energy that you put out, and it's, you just feel different. And so I would do it during times that, like, I don't know, you're trying, like, not that makeup makes you feel confident, but maybe you're putting on your makeup, you're just, I feel so confident today, you know, whatever. Or maybe you're working out, I feel so confident today, I always feel so confident and strong when I work out. Like, whatever it is, like, whatever it is that you find yourself doing daily, try to incorporate those kind of affirmations into your daily life, because they become a part of you. With all affirmations, you should be doing that, but, like, specifically with something like confidence, incorporate it into something that you maybe take pride in, or like some sort of hobby that you enjoy, because it, like, associates your confidence and your self-worth with a positive hobby that you already love. So let's say you like painting or something, you're like, oh, I'm such a great painter, like, I just love feeling so confident, like, I just feel so happy, so uplifted. I think that's another big part of, like, manifesting confidence too, is it's like, obviously you're manifesting confidence, but on top of that, it's like, okay, you want to embody that too. So a confident person, again, not that confident people are indestructible, you still get in bad moods, but, like, for the most part, if you're confident, you're going to be a more positive person, and you're going to be somebody that looks at the brighter side of things, or looks at the cup half full. Like, you're going to want to make the best of situations because you're confident and you know that that's what you deserve. And again, you could say things like that too, like, I get the best of everything because that's what I deserve. I earn everything that I have. I earn every manifestation that I have. I deserve every blessing that I get. I deserve every manifestation that I get, because that's what you would say as a confident person. You wouldn't wonder if you are good enough. Again, these are all different affirmations you can say. Like, if it's a specific thing that you're struggling with, you can say, I always know my self-worth. It's always easy for me to know my self-worth. People see the way that I carry myself, and I carry myself with confidence. I never wonder if I'm good enough. I always know that I'm more than good enough. And, you know, and those, again, these statements are all reinforcements of confidence, but they also just carry into so many different areas of your life, and they just make your mindset a better place to be. Basically, you can't escape your mind, which is a good and bad thing, but, you know, so make it a good place to be. Assume that you're confident. Why wouldn't you be? Like, who's going to argue with you? Somebody's going to say you're not confident. Cool, who cares? Because once you're confident, you build up that confidence. You are secure in yourself. You know that whatever anybody else says or sees in you or doesn't see in you does not matter. It only matters how you feel about yourself, and you know that you're confident. So literally, that's all that matters. So yeah, I'm trying to think of other ones. Those are the main ones, because it's just like, it doesn't have to be something specific. Like I say with all affirmations, it doesn't have to be anything specific. It doesn't have to be a certain way that you say them or write them or whatever. You don't, just do what feels comfortable to you. And say what feels comfortable to you. Like I always say affirmations, or form your affirmations in a way that is natural to how you talk. You know, maybe pretend like you're talking to a friend when you are saying your affirmations or reading them or whatever it is that you do, but just do it in a way that's natural to you, because it not only will be easier for you to incorporate and be able to say your affirmations, but it will also be easier for your mind to, like, believe it, I guess, or it'll be easier for your mind to conform to that idea, and, like, to incorporate that mindset change, because it's like you're communicating with your mind in a way that it's used to, if that makes sense. So that is pretty much all that I have for manifesting confidence. But before I go, I wanted to say that I have officially launched one-on-one coaching. I'm so excited. So basically I'm going to launch it through Patreon, just because I think it'll be a little bit easier to do, like, payment and stuff like that. It'll be email coaching, but if you ever want to hop on, like, a Zoom call or whatever, because sometimes you just need to talk out what you're feeling, especially when you're first starting out with manifesting and maybe you're stressing, struggling, whatever. So I'm open to that. So yeah, basically what I'm going to do for my email clients is through Patreon, it's going to be a monthly thing. It's like something that you pay for monthly. So during that time, we'll be sending emails. Like I said, maybe hop on a Zoom call now and then if you want to, if you feel like it would help you. I will write down your, like, custom affirmations, and we'll go through those, and basically it'll just be like a step-by-step guide. You will always have me, because it, like, I respond to comments and messages and, you know, stuff pretty much everywhere, but that, though, I still will, I'm not gonna stop doing that, but, like, the emails will be my first priority. So yeah, I don't have any clients yet, so I don't know. I'm gonna schedule it out, but I'm gonna figure out something once I kind of figure out what my workload is gonna be. But yeah, so actually I lied, I have one client already that's signed up, which is so exciting. Because I haven't even officially launched my Patreon, but I put it in my bio and then I got a notification that somebody like had already subscribed, and I was like, oh my god. But yeah, so there's gonna be three tiers. So the third tier is my email coaching. The other two tiers show, you'll be able to see it all in the thing, and I'm gonna make a community post about it. So you can see what you're getting in each tier. But the first tier is like a VIP group, and you can vote on next video topic ideas. You can request video topic ideas, all of that. So the VIP group will be anybody else that joins, myself, I'll obviously be in there. And then the second tier is all of that plus live streams, live Q&As, I think something else. I was like negotiating it for so long. But so the main thing though that I want to say is that other than the fact that I'm launching coaching, is that if you become a Patreon member at any tier between now and the 17th, I want to say 16th or 17th, I'll put it on here. But if you become a Patreon member at any tier between now and the 17th, you will get a free downloadable affirmation starter kit, affirmation sheet. It's just going to be like a general list of affirmations. And it's not like you have to say all of them, but I just wanted to give you ideas. Maybe you can pull from them, modify a couple, you know, whatever works for you. But if you're struggling to write your own affirmations or find affirmations that resonate with you, it'll hopefully be a good starting point. So yeah, that'll be a little digital freebie that comes with anybody that joins my Patreon group at any tier between now and the 17th. You will get a download for that. So yeah, that's pretty much it. Very exciting. Oh, but what I wanted to break hole was that, like, I am not going to put any of my content behind a paywall or have it be anything that you have to pay for. Like, all of these videos telling you about how to do certain things with manifesting, all of that will remain free. I'm not putting any of that. You're not going to have to ever pay for what you see here. Basically, what's going to be on Patreon is obviously the coaching, but also it'll just be little things like that, like the affirmation sheet, like just different like tips or like little tools, like additional things that you can use that can help you. And then obviously the VIP group is there. And like I said, I'm going to be doing live streams and stuff like that. But yeah, all of your main information will be here. So don't feel like you're missing out on anything, or, you know, I just don't want it to feel like I'm pushing things on you, because I know that a lot of manifestation coaches, not that they, I mean, some of them push stuff, but I feel like for the most part, it's just like very expensive, very like not even accessible. Like, even if you wanted to get into coaching with somebody, it's like usually sold out or something. But yeah, I just wanted to make it so there were accessible tools at every price range. Like, I am not trying to make things expensive. And like I said, you have all of your main information here. So if you can't afford anything, but definitely don't go out and like feel like you need to buy anything. You are good here. But for anybody that wants extra help, extra support, that is available for you, and it's at a cost that I think is accessible and affordable, which is the main goal. I just want to be able to help you guys as best as I can. And yeah, so that's pretty much it. Like I said, all the information will be in the description box. There'll be a community post about it. I'll make sure that it's, when I'm editing this, I'll make sure that points are driven home that need to be. But yeah, so again, I hope that I was able to help you guys today. If you have not yet subscribed, please do, if I helped you out in any way. Yeah, your guys' comments make my day. I'm so excited again for coaching, just to be able to have another outlet to help you guys in a more like one-on-one environment. But yeah, so thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye.